Where's your brother-in-law?
Here's Jim Emery. He's been working on this for the past 3 hours. Look at by the time he figures it out, we'll be going home. Look at this guy. Right out of the 50s, especially with the hat on. Yeah. He's a dad from the 50s with the hat. Yeah. What the hell's he making out there? Atomic bomb or something?
In Napoli, where love is king, when boy meets girl, here's what they sing. When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella.
Bravo, John!
Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a gay tarantella. Lucky fella. When the stars make you drool, just like Pasta Basil, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love.
Right. Okay, so the first one.
It's okay because Tia, by the time Tia, by the time we get it, it's okay to have more than one verse.
All right. We're gonna start. Oh,
Shine on Harvest Moon. Here we go.
What key are we in?
Shine on harvest moon up in the sky.
Turn it up.
I am
since January, February, June, and July. I'm hungry.
Ain't no time to stay. Outdoors and food. So shine on
harvest moon
for me and my gal.
Live from Leisure Village in Orange County, California. It's the Bob Hope Special with Anna, the chemist. Come on, sing it, honey, sing it.
Shine on harvest
moon. For me and my gal.
I met you.
Where?
In the hospital.
Oh, yes, that's right.
I remember his voice.
Can't forget again.
Shine on, harvest moon up in the sky. Since January, April, June, or July. Snowtime, tain't no time to stay outdoors and spoon. Shine on, harvest moon for me and my gal.
Okay, here's the words to the second song. Okay, if you knew Susie, here we go.
Okay.
I will in a little bit.
Got a sweetie known as Susie. In the words of Shakespeare, she's a wow.
She's a floozy.
I have got a sweetie known as Susie. In the words of Shakespeare, she's a wow. Though all of you may know her too, I'd like to shout right now. If you knew Susie like I know Susie, oh, 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 what a girl. There's none so classy as this fair lassie. Oh, oh, oh my goodness, what a chassis. I had a mustache as cute as a pup. Susie kissed me, and she burned a damn thing up. If you knew Susie like I know Susie, oh, oh, what a girl.
Oh, you may know her. I'd like to shout right now.
Oh, oh, what a gal. Remember this one? You know, you remember this one, darling? This is from 1820. After this, we'll sing a couple of dirty ones. You know what I mean? From the English music halls, if you know what I'm saying. All right. Bring back memories, sir?
Yes, it does.
Any good ones?
Some. Not all.
It makes me want to puke. Happy
day. All right, how about this, huh? She got what?
She's got a really good voice.
Who the does this? Oh, yeah. She told me she's about to puke. Days are here again. The sky is blue again.
Sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again.
Sing it, Gary.
Troubles are gone. There's still a
can. Go eat a cow.
Let us sound loud and now. Happy days are here again.
Happy days are here again. The skies above are clear again. Let us sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again. All together, shout it now. There's no one who can doubt it now. So let's tell the world all about it now. Happy days are here again. Your cares and troubles are gone. There'll be no more from now on. Happy days are here again. The skies above are clear again. Let us sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again. So long, sad times. So long, bad times. We are rid of you at last. Cloudy gay times, cloudy gray times. You are now a thing of the past.
Happy days are here again. The skies above are clear again. Let us sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again. All together, shout it now. There's no one who can doubt it now. So let's tell the world about it now. Happy days are here again. Your cares and troubles are gone. There'll be no more from now on. Happy days are here again. The skies above are clear again. Let us sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again. Happy days are here again. The skies above are clear again. Let us sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, everybody. Here's a little toast to the lady of the hour.
Hello, hello.
Here she is, the queen of the queen of the Nile, with her navy cap.
It's Captain Posner.
Captain Posner.
She used to be. Captain Posner was in the Marines.
A Marine.
So I don't know why she's with the Navy all of a sudden. Maybe they pay better. Susan, we were on the freeway. It took us so long to get here. I was afraid by the time we got here, you'd be 94. I just want to say hello to you. We love you very much. You look marvelous, darling.
You look marvelous. Absolutely marvelous.
And here's to your 100th birthday, okay?
Yay!
No!
To Susan Posner. Safe for democracy.
Yay!
Whatever that is.
That's okay. Bye-bye. Okay. Who would like to give a toast? And I thought, since my mom is the word person in the family, word person in the family, I thought it would be fitting to read one of your poems.
Yes.
That you wrote. This is a poem I would like to read too. One is about Mother's Day. It's called...
Oh, dear.
I know. Oh, dear. It's called Good Thoughts. The best part of Mother's Day is to find that you have lived through it and didn't kill a single child, husband, or mother-in-law, and you know that the next Mother's Day is a long 364 days away.
That's good.
So thank you for sharing your wonderful sense of humor. And then
she rolls her eyes.
That's good, Susan.
I wasn't being funny.
No.
And it could fly across a number of different holidays.
We're chuckling now, but isn't it nice we can laugh now? And then I was really debating, I don't know if you remember these, between Transformation at Fedco Exit or Answer on the Scenic Trail. Do you have a preference?
Repeat that again.
I want the Fedco Exit. I always had food there.
Not Fedco.
Not Fedco.
All right. Answer on the Scenic Trail. Scenic Trail is a trail above the cabin that...
And
Ida Wild.
And this is not funny or heavy.
It's very affirming. Droplets of rain cling to the tips of pine needles, waiting the moment when the universe says, now. The curving path, red, brown, moist, wears a soft paisley shawl of multicolored leaves, waiting for hikers or a covey of quail. Mists rise like ghostly smoke from secret fires up to join the waiting, strangely bright gray sky of afternoon. Straight overhead, so straight it hurts one's neck to look, a brazen patch of brilliant blue crashes this somber rainy day event, waiting for nothing, shouting the gray-skied afternoon a yes.
Beautiful.
So, yay. Wow. And a big yes. Very to good. You. Very good. Thank you, Monique, for giving me the perfect introduction. Oh, you're welcome. Seriously. So, Mom, you are extraordinary. You're like a force of nature. And what I think of in like the most succinct description of you is you are a yes to life. You just
that's
walk around with a yes. You are yes, an embodied yes, which is like exhilarating and fabulous to be around. And I just want to acknowledge you for the
visionary, pioneering spirit. My mom, you probably all know because you know her, you know, she's a bit of a wild woman. And I'm saying a wild woman in the most beautiful kind of sense. A wild woman in the sense of a woman that was not tamed by her times or her circumstances. You know, she was not tamed by her times or her circumstances. Here she is at 93. It's just, it's so inspiring, Mom. It's just so inspiring and so beautiful. And for me personally, you know, the gifts. She's like, yes, tell me. She's a Leo and she's not ashamed of it. It's good.
Gotta own your sign.
You know, the things that feed my soul, really the very, very most, the things that are the most important to me, that like why you'd want to get up in the morning, my sense of beauty, my love of nature, my love of the written word. I mean, I'm the daughter of a librarian. I own a bookstore. I was raised as a Unitarian. I was given the right and the responsibility, imbued with it, that I had to sort out my own spiritual beliefs path and to walk my path. Jenny Quinn, you know this one. And so here I am, the owner of a metaphysical bookstore. Like, just a total, complete fulfillment and a deep bow.
Yay!
Of respect and love and gratitude. Happy birthday!
Yay!
All right, so, my two greatest memories. I'm daughter of Gary and Karen Finkel. My two greatest memories of Aunt Susan. Number one, she sat down with me the Christmas giveaways or
the rally party.
And just wanted to sit down and tell me how I'm such an observant person. And she had already critiqued my whole personality and wanted to tell me about it. And she said, well, follow up with this with a chat at my house.
Oh.
Okay, so I came over here. And we had a great conversation over cherries. And she wanted to know about my love life.
Of course.
And this was when I was in 12th grade.
Which one was that?
So she goes, so what's your boyfriend's name? Go, Ian. What an ugly face you have to make when you say his name.
Thanks, Aunt Susan.
Okay, we all knew at that point.
Ian's all gone. Don't worry.
Anyhow, cheers to you, Aunt Susan.
Oh,
for being the most great aunt.
I'm not prepared for this. Thank God.
You were up.
You didn't read your invitation, Gary?
Okay.
Off of what Kellyanne said, to go off of your wonderful advice to young people. When I was in 12th grade,
introduce me.
We're the granddaughters.
We're the granddaughters.
Through Monica.
What's that mean?
Anna and Sarah. Anna and Sarah.
Great niece.
So, my grandmother told me in 12th grade that a way to a man's heart was through pudding. Yep. So we'd like to thank you for our wonderful relationships, all possible through your advice on to feed them pudding.
And your bread pudding recipe that we have safeguarded now and passed along.
So thank you for getting us wonderful boyfriends, because without your pudding advice, that it may not have happened.
Where would we be
without that? Cheers to you. Thank you so much.
Yeah,
I thought steak.
We are not a good boyfriend. We just learned that right now.
Like old time, you sing a song for Mama.
Oh, see? No, Mom, not in front of all these people.
Joe, you sing it for Mama.
In Napoli, where love is king, when boy meets girl, here's what they sing. Ah! When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
You've had too much wine, that's amore.
Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella.
Bravo, John.
When the stars make you drool, just like Pasta Basil, that's amore.
Like a pasta puzzle, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud on your feet, you're in love.
When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signora.
Mama!
Excuse me, but you see back in old Napoli, that's immoral.
If you still kiss your girl after garlic and oil, that's amore.
That's amore.
If you call her your pet, though she's shaped like spaghetti, that's amore.
That's amore. Bells will ring.
Ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling.
Sing me to
Bella. Vita Bella, Vita Bella.
That's amore.
Tutte quante cantate, everybody sing.
Street, your feet, you're in love. Walk them, dream. It's signora.
Scusami, but you see
back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Signore,
that's amore.
I can embellish it a little bit in the sense that we have my mom's side of the family, and we have my dad's side of the family, and we have cousins on both. And Aunt Susan and Uncle Lou, especially Aunt Susan, always made sure that as family we were together, and we were the cousins. My mom's side of the family, not so much. Kind of come back in our later years here a little communication, but this has been our family.
Yes.
It has been our family. And it's just been special. It's just been a special relationship. Mike and I grew up, we were the twins, we looked like.
You were the twins.
Can you believe it? Yeah, and a little resemblance to that one over there too.
Maybe. I think we're more, got it.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I don't know. I was always Kelly, you were
Corey,
so.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, right.
So it's been incredible time, incredible experience. My cousins and now my cousin's children, all headed up by the sea captain.
Okay, so shall we have some more songs?
On the railroad, all the live long day, I've been working on the railroad just to pass the time away. Can't you hear the whistle blowing right up early in the morning? To hear the whistle blowing, Dinah, blow your horn. Dinah, won't you blow? Dinah, won't you blow? Dinah, won't you blow your horn? Dinah, won't you blow? Dinah, won't you blow? Dinah, won't you blow your horn?
We always seem to be able to talk.
Seem to what?
talk. Have conversations together.
He said talk, Susan,
we
talk.
We seem to be able to communicate.
Don't be away from the plane floor when the baby stuff is going
on. Making all the pictures.
Use your teacher voice.
Like I said, I have a special, to me, you have a special place in my heart because we always seem to be able to communicate with one another. And I like talking with you. You just seem to have, there's an easiness in having conversation with you. And I was very concerned about you when you were sick. And I must say that you have... three very loving daughters that supported you a lot, 100%. They were on your side. They were determined to make you well, that for you to want yourself to get well, and they didn't give up. And you haven't given up either.
No, we didn't.
They didn't give up on you, and you didn't give up on them. And look at you. You look like you're the healthiest person here right now.
Hey, wait a second.
Except for healthy.
You look marvelous.
And you look marvelous,
it's
darling.
It's better to look good than to feel good. You know that?
You know, my dear, my father used to say to me, Nando, don't be a schnook. It's not how you feel. It's how you look. He was marvelous. But you, darling... absolutely marvelous. And this is from my heart, which is deep inside my body. It's better to look good than to feel good. Get down!
As
family.
They say.
Yeah. Yeah.
So whatever it is you're doing right now, keep it up, but watch it. Don't eat too many of those fatty, sugary foods, though, because they make you sick. You know? Lots of veggies and fruits with protein. I think you're going to live... I hope that you live to be 100 plus, because we really need you around. Okay? All right. I love you. Bye. And there's the male stripper's coming any minute.
Make sure he takes his hearing aid out when he
answers. Hello, I'm Betty Smirnoff.
Yay!
And I have been friends from the church for many, many years, but it wasn't until I moved here to Leisure World that we became very best friends. The best friend I've ever had. And I still have her, and I'm so glad. Thank you.
And Wes was not even supposed to be standing up.
I think I predate Betty.
Do you want a chair?
No, that's okay. I'm supposed to stay off my feet to help a doctor. My time with Susan, remember when you lived on Ninth Street?
Yeah.
And we used to go for walks because it was so easy. I would walk over to your house, which was only a couple of blocks from mine, and we exchanged confidences. I won't embarrass anybody here because I learned things about you that you wouldn't want me to know, perhaps. and she learned things about my kids that perhaps they wouldn't want me to know. But it was good venting. And I sure miss Susan when she died. I sure miss Susan when she moved away. Because there wasn't anybody else who took her place. So, Susan, I miss those times. I don't know whether they were months or years. And I'm a little bit younger than you. Not much, but I'm trying to catch up. So anyway, happy birthday. You're one of my favorite people. You know that.
Hi, I'm Jenny, and I've known Susan since she first moved to Long Beach. And I will always think of you as the most receptive person I've ever met when person is dealing with difficult feelings. And she's a person I came to when somebody I was engaged to died suddenly. And it was such a long, long, hard time getting used to not being with him anymore. And she's the person who was a great friend to my former husband when his last couple of years were really hard. She was just there for him, and he depended on seeing her on Thursdays. Susan comes on Thursdays. That's so powerful. And then further, she comforted me when I lost another wonderful man in my life. My life has been full of wonderful men. Like Susan.
You go, girl.
And anyway, I just want to thank you for your sensitivity, your unfailing generosity of spirit and ability to listen. Even when a person is saying things are hard to listen to, you were always there for me, and I hope I can return the favors as much as possible. Anyway, I love you.
I have known Susan for only a short time, 7 years. That's all. And I known her as the girl from Massachusetts, because that's where she came from. And that's where I lived for a long time. And we talked about her early life in Massachusetts quite a while. And I just wanted to say, Susan, you are the girl from Massachusetts, the one I really love, and I want to wish you a real happy birthday.
After the ball is over.
It's a beautiful song. But we're going to move to, I'm looking over. Do we need music to this?
Moving over.
A four-leaf clover.
I overlook before. La, 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 la.
The third is the roses that grow in the lane.
Oh, I like the trumpet.
Meaning
somebody I adore.
I'm looking over a four-leaf clover that I've overlooked before. Everybody!
Gary, what's your feeling about marching?
She did not do a good thing.
What are your real feelings?
It's a great activity for the military and people that really are highly engaged in the march. Me personally, I like to watch it but not participate.
It's
Karen, what are your feelings about marching?
She loves it.
Hmm? What's your feelings about marching?
I have a carrot in my mouth. I have a carrot in my mouth.
And wherever we go, you will
that's what the posters do. We march.
That's right.
We'll be marching.
Today and making it a nice party, and I just really appreciate it. I appreciate it a lot. It was fun seeing all of you, and it was fun being well enough to walk around and play volleyball. Did I play volleyball?
Yes.
Did you actually get the
Wait, yeah. Yeah. Best Aunt Susan ever.
Yeah.
Three.
Three.
What else do you think?
I want to wake you up.
What else
do you think? Can you give us some words of wisdom?
Susan, what else do you think?
Oh my God, what words of wisdom?
What do you recommend?
Wait, polite.
Words of wisdom. Go.
This little lady would like some words of wisdom.
Give us the secret to life. See, that my sister got married.
Okay, you
got
to listen now for long enough for her to talk. Okay. What do you think?
Oh, that's what I want. Oh, that's going to help my words of wisdom. Don't go back too high. They have knocked me over. So I came out here many years ago to California.
A little louder.
I came out here to California many years ago, and I didn't know people. I didn't have any friends. I didn't have any family. And circumstances were difficult. And now look what has come about. It's taken a long time. But I've appreciated every opportunity I had to become a part of a family. And I really feel that I did. And it was just a wonderful family for all of us. And I know you continue to be, and I wanted us to have these toys to play with so that we can play together as the children come along. Because there'll be more kids. You know, we need more toys.
To Tamara with me.
So, just don't expect too much. Just do the best you can with what comes your way and make it as good as you can. And hang in there, and it probably will be good enough to have done your best. Just keep on doing your best, and it'll be okay.
Susan, you know what Jane Fonda said the other day?
What'd she say?
They asked her for some words of wisdom. She said, "Don't worry about being interesting. Just be interested."
Oh, yeah.
Just be interested.
Just be interested. You know. Jane Fonda said that?
Don't worry about being interesting.
What do you think
Just
of that?
Just be interested.
Gary.
I think that's one.
You want some?
Don't be ordinary. That's just fine. I read her whole book.
Yeah.
That's her biography. Imagine there's something that I can do.
Yeah, I think...
I'm thinking that trivia group that you're so insistent that you're not going to join downstairs. You know that trivia, the group that gets together and the guy does the trivia questions?
Yeah.
Yeah,
like
you?
I like that.
Have you done that?
Yeah.
Oh,
good.
Okay.
I did that. One of the highlights of my book. Oh, my God. Yeah. You know you guys are. You're so original. I can hardly stand it. You're the first kid that ever did that.
When you are in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming.
Signore!
Che ti vuoi?
Prendilo!
Scusami, but you see,
back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Signore,
that's amore.
That's all, folks.